Good morning, everyone. Welcome to today's Sunshine Meeting of the Chester County Board of Commissioners. It is Tuesday, March 18th. It is 10 a.m. My name is Ryan Costello. To my right, Terrence Farrell. My left, Kathy Cazone. We're your Board of Commissioners. And this meeting is being videotaped for broadcast on www.chesco.org. If you are making a presentation during today's meeting, I ask that you use the podium to our right and state your name and position before making your presentation or comments. Announcements.
Thank you, Commissioner. We have a proclamation for Intellectual Disability Awareness Month that we're doing today.
Good morning. County of Chester Proclamation. Whereas an intellectual disability is defined as a disability characterized by significant limitations both in intellectual functioning and in adaptive behavior as expressed in conceptual, social, and practical adaptive skills, which originates before age 21. And whereas people with an intellectual disability are and desire to be valued members of society, our family, friends, neighbors, and coworkers. And whereas community recognition and acceptance coupled with appropriate education and community-based services continue to be vital to empowering citizens with intellectual disabilities to find opportunities for employment, develop relationships, and pursue their dreams while sharing their gifts and contributing to our community in a meaningful way. And whereas Chester County established itself as a leader in the Commonwealth in respecting people first language by renaming the county office to the Department of Mental Health, Intellectual, and Developmental Disabilities in March of 2010. Now therefore be it resolved that the Board of Commissioners, County of Chester, Commonwealth of Pennsylvania, hereby proclaims its support for Intellectual Disability Awareness Month during March 2014, recognizing that individuals with an intellectual disability are respected citizens in Chester County and are contributing members of a diverse and proactive community that promotes inclusion, dignity, compassion, and respect. Signed by the Board of Commissioners, Ryan Costello, Kathy Cazone, and Terrence Farrell.
Thank you, Commissioner. Accepting the proclamation is Bridget Thrash from our Department MHIDD. Bridget.
Good morning, Commissioners. Bridget Thrash, Deputy Administrator for Chester County Mental Health, Intellectual, and Developmental Disabilities. I want to thank you this morning for recognizing Intellectual Disability Awareness Month again this year. As a county office, we have worked very hard with individuals, families, and our community at large to develop supports and services for people to be successful in their lives. A primary focus over the past year that you may have heard of and you'll continue to hear about is our Employment First initiative. So this morning we brought along with us Carol Hewitt from the ARC of Chester County, along with Amanda Ramirez, who is receiving the ARC supports to be successful in her job out in the community and her job coach.
Hi, I'm Carol Hewitt, and I too would like to say thank you to the commissioners for the proclamation and for all your efforts to support people with disabilities to work and participate fully in their community. Amanda Ramirez is a great example of someone who's working and participating in her community, and she would like to say a couple words about the wonderful job that she has.
Hi, and thank you for having me here today. My name is Amanda Ramirez, and I have been working as a salon assistant at Salon Secrets in Kenneth Square since December 2013. It was a long journey to get where I am now in my career. I always knew I wanted to work in the beauty industry. I love doing my friends and family's hair and nails, but I wasn't sure how I was going to get a job without schooling or experience. My job coach, Ms. Christie, and I tried to apply and get a job at many salons, but no one called me. So we decided to talk with Ms. Heather, the owner of Paul's Beauty Academy. And she allowed Ms. Christie and I to come in so I could learn what I need to work in a salon. I wash Miss Christie's hair a lot, and I think she likes it too. Once we put that I had gone to beauty school on my resume, I began to have interviews, but I still didn't have the experience. I was interviewed by Salon Secrets back in October 2013, but I wasn't offered the job, but we didn't give up. Miss Christie had heard about an internship program that Salon Secrets had. It wouldn't be paid for a month, but I would have the opportunity to show them my skills. And there was the opportunity for me to be hired after the internship was completed. I am happy to say after I completed the internship that they hired me. Now I am working in the job of my dreams. And I wanted to thank everyone who helped me get there. I would like to say a special thanks to the ARC, and thank you today for hearing about my special career journey.
Thank you for that presentation. Next, a presentation of the Chester County mobile app.
The screen's gonna come down in a moment, so hopefully.
Did you say the screen's coming down?
It's hopefully coming down.
Good morning, Commissioners. I'm Becky Brain. I'm the Communications Coordinator for Chester County, and with me is Frank Cipriano yes. from DCIS. And we're here today to present to you the Chester County Government new mobile app. It's entitled Chesco Connect. It's available now in the Apple iStore.
Hold on just one second, because we need to make sure that I can figure out how to work the thing that I probably should have figured out how to work 3 years ago that turns it on for everyone up here. But I'm ready to do the mobile app.
I'll say a few words first just to
Very
give
good.
Some time. It's available in the Google Play Store and also the Apple iStore. And before we go through the functionalities and place the app there on the screen for you to look at and watch rather than start playing with, I hope, I'd just like to give you some facts and figures about our website, www.chesco.org.
I don't know.
That was the awe factor. Since we got that, Frank.
I'm trying to get it.
Is it popping up? Is the baby picture up there, too?
Baby's oh, okay.
Since the launch of the current website in October 2012, we've actually had 1.9 million visits to chesco.org. More than 144,000 of those, or 7%, were from mobile users, tablets and mobile phones. And of those 144,000, nearly 80% were from iPads. In the second half of 2013, mobile traffic increased by nearly 30%, so it's going on. And last month, February 2014, mobile traffic actually increased by 211%. compared to January. And we're surmising that that's obviously because of the ice storm and the fact that people didn't have a lot of power and were using their mobile phones and their iPads to find out what they needed to know from Chesco.org. So it's interesting that mobile traffic is actually increasing tremendously, and all of this points to the fact that a Chester County government mobile app is actually a welcome addition to our communications portfolio. So onto the app, and here you can see Chesco Connect, the app. Frank and I are going to briefly describe, hopefully, and demonstrate the 16 functionalities on the app. There we go.
Wire's not playing.
And there we go. The wire's a little loose, but we're going to work through it. What we want to sort of explain is that all of these apps are taken from our most frequently visited web pages, and then also information that is general useful information for Chester County citizens. I'll talk you through some of them. We'll demonstrate some of them. Chester County News, you see in the top left-hand corner, is actually a two-week listing of news information that's been posted onto our website. It's a combination of all of the departments plus the main page that actually submit press releases and post them onto our website. So you get a nice two-week view of the kind of news information that's being posted out from Chester County. Then onto the jobs functionality. This is actually a list of all current Chester County job postings, with the option to then select individual categories. So you can go with all categories, or you can say, I'm just looking for one specific type of job, go into that kind of category and see what is available from that category. If you actually click onto that, it gives a complete description of the job, when it was posted, all of the details for the hours, the shift, the salary, and you actually have a function to be able to click there and apply on your tablet or on your phone, or then go to the website and apply as well. The county calendar is a calendar, as per the county news releases, that is a combination of all web page calendars from across all the different departments. So you've got information from the health department there, from the emergency services, from the commissioner's office, even manure management manual workshop from the conservation district. So it gives you a nice range of all the different types of activities that are going on that are based on our calendar. FAQs is a functionality that we have on our website that is actually incredibly useful for mobile application. Many people may not know it, but we have a really, really comprehensive list of frequently asked questions from many of the departments within the county. And this translates really well onto a mobile app. So say if you've been called up for jury service and you have a number of questions, you can click onto FAQs, go into jury service, and there are very simple, easy to read questions and answers there that tell you anything from how much will I be paid, where do I park, where do I go, all kinds of information there. And that runs across the board for many of our departments. The Parks Department is a reflection of the homepage of the Chester County Parks website. It lists all of the special activities that are going on, the spring and summer programs, the special events like Sheep and Wool Day that's coming up soon. Also lists each of the parks and each of the trails individually. Answers questions like how to book a pavilion, all kinds of information like that. So at the moment, that's a reflection of the park's homepage. The department directory is another really useful functionality for the mobile app. It lists every single department, and from there, you can select one. It should ask you if you want to choose your location on the mobile app. It comes up with the map, all of the details of the specific address of that department, who the department head is, the address, the fax number, the website, the email address, and then if you want to find out how to get there, you just press directions, and it will take you from where you are to where you want to be. So it's a really useful tool for saying, I need to go to the Recorder of Deeds office. Where is it, and how do I get there? So that's the department directory. The search function is as per the website. If you're not sure what is covered by these apps and you want to find something that is on our website that can be translated through the mobile app, you just use the search function. social media as well is broken down into the different types of social media that some of our county departments have. So it's broken down into Facebook, Twitter, Flickr in this instance, and Pinterest. And then as and when we may add further social media types for different departments in the county, they will be added there as well. So that will take you to our emergency services home Facebook page, to the health Facebook page, to planning's Facebook page. It's a nice link to find out information that's ongoing through the social media. I'll come back to restaurant inspections. Emergency alerts is, the beauty of this is it's linked to Ready Notify PA, and it covers the southeastern PA area. So as and when there's any emergency notices, anything that comes through for Chester County, that's relevant for Chester County residents, those who aren't signed up for Ready Notify PA can actually get this through our mobile app now, and that may even hopefully encourage them to sign up for Ready Notify PA as well. The health clinic functionality shows a number of different citizen information on the types of health clinics that are available, and it's coming, there we go. So you had a full calendar of the clinic, what's available through the health department, and then broken down into things like adult immunizations and childhood immunizations. The other thing with this that's nice is that if you go into adult immunizations, hopefully there is there somewhere a link for Spanish, there we go, for childhood immunizations and in summers as well. You can click the prompt and it will put it all into Spanish as well. So the entire mobile app isn't capable of being translated into Spanish at the moment, something that may come in the future, but certainly where there are web pages on our website that have that functionality already built in, you can actually do that on the mobile app as well. From there, YouTube, we actually have a county YouTube channel, and some of the different departments have already started posting information onto the YouTube channel through promotional information, training information, public meetings. And so this is something that's useful and I think will actually grow in use as the different departments see what's available. And some of the information, say from MHIDD that's come through, is getting some really great hits on our regular website, and this will just encourage it even more. So I think that's really good. Courts is a reflection, as with parts, it's a reflection of the homepage on chesco.org, and so it lists the different information about all the different court departments, the judicial calendar, the legal calendar. It's a nice sort of general information about courts right now. And social services. Now, this is one that is linked to ReferWeb, which is our Health and Human Services directory that's available on our website. It's not completely mobile app friendly at the moment, but it is able to be interactive. The nice thing is that this means we're able to get ReferWeb out there on all of the mobile units, and it will be something that the different caseworkers and people can use when they're meeting with people. ReferWeb is and does have their own mobile app, and we're currently talking with them and working about how we can translate and work and add their mobile app to ours. So that's something that is good and will get even better. Land use planning is a reflection of the Planning Commission's web pages. It goes into the details about planning, about landscapes too, and it has a nice drop-down menu that's a mobile user-friendly menu for going on to.
Did Ronald approve of the helmet for the...
We just did it without him.
Something tells me you would have chose something else.
Feedback is a contact us form. It's something that we have available on our website, and it's just saying if you have a comment, a concern, a question, hopefully a compliment, please contact us and let us know, and we will be able to help you out. The final functionality that I want to focus on, which is unique to Chester County and we're really, really excited about, and it's one that we think will really pique the interest of citizens, is our restaurant inspection functionality. If you're about to head out to your restaurant, or if you're at your restaurant and you want to be brave and say, I like this restaurant, I hope the health department does too, you can go on and you can search the restaurant that you're going to. I love the Green Street Grill in Downingtown. I go there for breakfast a lot, so I sort of asked Frank to search the Green Street Grill. That comes up, and there you can see that happily there are no risk factor violations and no good retail practice violations. So I'm going to go back there on Saturday for breakfast. The information is there on every restaurant, every food service unit in Chester County that has been inspected by the health department. There's a brief explanation of what a risk factor is and what a good retail practice is. If you want to find out more beyond that, if you see that your restaurant has, you know, a few risk factors and you think, what does that mean? You can then click onto the restaurant inspection website link that is there. That takes you to, let me get this word right, the PA Food Safety System website. And there will be more information. You can search your restaurant, and there will be more information on the exact comments that the health department made, the follow-up that they made after the risk factors were remediated. So it gives you a little bit more information. There is also a prompt there for a complaint. So if you haven't had a tremendous experience at your restaurant, you can send a notice to...
Is it a complaint or a concern?
Complaint. That one is.
Interesting how we use complaints for restaurant inspections, but when it relates to our stuff, it's concerns.
It's all in the words, that's right. So there we have the Chester County mobile app. I invite you all to download it, delve into it, play with it, tell your friends, tell your family. It's something that I think is going to be, you know, really useful. The beauty of this app means that we can continue to develop functionalities and add them or replace them, make them seasonal. So in May and November, we're going to be able to go to voter services and put election results on. In September, we can put one functionality on that looks at health clinics. In the summer, West Nile virus, things that come and go that are very useful for citizens to know about, we can add and take. And as Civic Plus, who's our host web provider and app provider, as they increase their functionalities and their capabilities, we'll be able to do that as well, which gives us even more chance to shout about it and talk about it at the time. Finally, I would just like to thank all of the web administrators who keep their web pages up to date and informative. All the different departments have designated web administrators, and without them, the depth and the breadth of the website would not be able to be kept up to date, and hence the mobile app would not be able to keep up to date. Also, I would like to point out Sue Morris and Carolyn Oakley, who are here today. Sue is from the Health Department, Carolyn from the Planning Commission, and they have been really, really helpful in preparing and creating some of the functionalities for the restaurant inspection, for the health clinics. They're what's helped to really make this a nice interactive mobile app for citizens. And also like to thank Frank Cipriano for overseeing it and working with Civic Plus as we go forward.
And Becky, could you mention the costs using Civic Plus versus trying to develop it on our own or buying something off the shelf from some other provider?
Correct me if I'm wrong, Frank, but when we put out a request for information from different companies to get an idea of designs and costs for a mobile app, we had a huge range of costs, even upward to, I think, $100,000 to create something like that. At the time, we were pleased to find out that Civic Plus, who was our web host, actually were developing and had just developed a mobile app capability at $5,000. So we jumped on it, we've worked with them, and we're really excited about it and know that it'll be able to continue from there.
How many other counties do you have an idea in the Commonwealth actually have a mobile app?
That I don't know. I can get back to you. I do know Montgomery County has one. They work with Civic Plus, and they have developed a mobile app. I'm not sure how many other capabilities. I will check that out for you then.
Well, I want to thank you both and all the folks that you recognize. I'm sure we all do for this tremendous work. It's a great job, and I think it only enhances our commitment to communicating with the public interactively both ways. I really do like the ability for the public to be able to respond and reach back to us at the county, whether it's a concern or a complaint, and hopefully some compliments too. So great job.
Chester County C-SPAN at your fingertips. Thank you for the presentation. And great job.
And this is just really the latest step in terms of the innovations we've taken through the website. I think we had a thorough review of our web capabilities about 3 or 4 years ago and decided that we needed to update and upgrade them. And we had the department administrators working together to make sure the pages were up to date and have all the information. And then we went to Civic Plus, and then we've gone to this mobile app. I think Chester County, in this kind of social media innovation, is really a powerhouse. And if you actually, Chester County innovation were electricity, we would be the leading power facility in the Commonwealth, generating more power than Limerick and Peach Bottom combined. So keep up the good work.
Moving along, the Board of Commissioners met in executive session on Wednesday, February 26th, 2014, to discuss personnel matters, and the minutes of our previous board meeting on February 26th, 2014 are before the board and will be voted on at our meeting on Thursday. Public comment on any agenda item. Mindful that there is another public comment portion of the meeting on anything else at the end of the meeting. There appearing to be none, we'll move along to bid awards under old business, the Department of Procurement and General Services. I'll speak slow so you can get over there, Pete, on time without a pause. Recommends that the Board of Commissioners award the attached bids. Mr. Navarro.
Good morning, Commissioners. Pete Navarro, Director of Procurement and General Services. We have two projects we would like to recommend for award today, Commissioners, as they are the lowest responsive and responsible bidders. The first is for janitorial supplies, bid number 015-402-1181A. The first vendor is Calico Industries, Inc., in the amount of $3,673.58. Central Poly Corporation, $9,479.50. Interborough Packaging, $112.40. Interline Brands, Inc., $755.90. Office Basics, $22,946. Paragon Maintenance and Supply, $5,475. Philip Rosenthal Company, Inc., $21,869.17. Pyramid School Products, $10,354.58. T. Frank McCall's, Inc., $4,720.50. W.B. Mason Company, Inc., $4,441.69. This award was awarded by line item. There are over 52 different line items. The various type of products being purchased through this are trash can liners, floor wax, furniture polish, glass cleaner, etc. The facilities that this particular bid covers is 313 West Market Street, the Exton Library, Youth Center, Chester County Prison, and the Pacopson Home. The next bid award recommendation is the Market Street Crosswalk Improvements, bid number 075-402-1180E. To Charles A. Higgins and Sons, Inc., in amount of $20,346.50.
What's the nature of the improvements there?
Is to install additional LED warning light bars and signs, to lower existing LED warning light bars and signs, and add additional yield to pedestrian and wait for vehicles to yield before crossing signs.
Okay. Seeing if you have any, you do not. Okay.
Thank you.
We'll move to new business. Resolution 2014 recommends that the board authorize emergency remedial measures to the Chester County Historical Courthouse.
Good morning, Commissioners. Steve Fromnick, Director of Facilities and Parks. As you're aware, we are currently in the process of upgrading, doing tenant improvements for the historic courthouse to bring the district court from Westchester into the historic courthouse. We've added ADA ramps and elevators to make it ADA compliant. Anticipating that the building would then be open for other uses, special events, etc., we decided to move forward on sprucing up the courtroom number one. And in the process of it, we noticed a problem in the southwest corner of the ceiling area of courtroom one, where the ceiling looked like it was drooping down. And upon further inspection with our architect, we found that one of the rafters had actually dropped about 5 to 7 inches. This was caused in part because back in 1966, there was an HVAC system that was installed in the building that actually channeled through the outer wall underneath the support of that truss and caused eventually the truss to crush the bricks that are supported it. So unfortunately, I have to say, after 167 years, we've had our first failure in the historic courthouse that we need to do some emergency repairs on. We don't recommend the courtroom number one be used until this repair is completed, and we believe that given the fact that we are finishing up the district court repairs at the end of March for a move-in of April, and the building will then be available to the public after that, that we get this emergency resolution started so that we can get the repairs put in place as soon as possible.
Any questions? Thank you. Resolution 2114. Request that we adopt a certain resolution which is embedded in an emergency solutions grant for DCED. Mr. Bakovitz.
Good morning, Commissioners. Pat Bakovitz, Director of the Department of Community Development. This resolution is attached to an item on the grants agenda, the submission of the Emergency Solutions Grant in the amount of $131,457. And I will speak to that as well during that part of the agenda, but this is a resolution that's required per that grant application.
Thank you. Next, it is recommended that the board approve the attached appointments and reappointments. Chester County Office of Aging Citizens Advisory Council appoint James Logue for a term ending April 1, 2017. Chester County Area Airport Authority appoint Richard Saylor for a term ending September 1, 2018. And Chester County Workforce Investment Board appoint Edward Piscopo for a term ending June 30th, 2014. 2015. And we will move now to the contracts agenda and start with children, youth, and families.
Good morning, Commissioners. Let me open my contract app here. We have one contract amendment actually for your review today, and it's comes out of the Juvenile Probation Office. It's an existing contract, a Delfoy, and they would like to add an amendment for residential services that focus on mental health services with for females, referred to as Susan's Place.
Thank you. Next, we have a whole host of contracts under community development.
Good morning, Commissioners. Pat Bakovitz, Department of Community Development. Community Development has four amendments and 17 contracts. I'm going to summarize a little bit. The amendments is to the first is to Unruh Turner Burke and Freeze, our legal service provider, to extend their term through the end of this year and provide an additional $50,000. The next amendment is to Phoenixville Borough for their Bridge Street Community Revitalization Program activity, and this amendment is to extend that term through June 30th of next year to give them some time to complete that activity. The third amendment is to Open Hearth for some additional contingency funding for their for the program they're providing through the Health Choices Reinvestment Funds, $91,309. And then the final amendment is to Human Services Incorporated, and this is a minor change of just funding sources, totally funding this contract now with housing trust funds as opposed to a combination of housing trust and emergency solutions grant funds. The 17 contracts are for the most part all renewals of our 2014 programs. There are a couple of exceptions to that, but the renewals include funding to Human Services Incorporated, Handicrafters, the W.C. Atkinson's Emergency Shelter, Life Transforming Ministries, Chester County OIC for two contracts, an additional contract to Life Transforming Ministries for their VITA program, Pennsylvania Home of the Sparrow, the Chester County Department of Drug and Alcohol, Ligway to Southeastern Pennsylvania, two contracts to Safe Harbor for the administration of the Mercy Shelter, Canadary Community Service for a continuation of their rapid rehousing programs, and funding to the Community Youth and Women's Alliance for the housing services that they provide both at the shelter and for rapid rehousing. The two contracts that are sort of unique, the first is to Full Circle, is a contract in the amount of $34,500 to provide some specific medical administrative assistant training for dislocated workers. This is a specific training being provided to connect dislocated workers back to employment and being funded by the Department of Labor and Industries Dislocated Worker National Mercy Grant. Then the other unique contract is the lease to vendor DTC 479TJW. This is the lease for the Thomas Jones Way property, 479 Thomas Jones Way, for the to move our youth employment center, which we call the Hood here in Westchester, to that facility, which will be adjacent to the CareerLink property.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Drug and alcohol.
Good morning, Commissioners. Vince Brand, Department of Drug and Alcohol Services. I have one item on the agenda this morning. That is a contract amendment for the COAD group, and that is to amend their contract up by the amount of $4,000 to provide additional services through their student assistance program.
Thank you. Go ahead.
Sorry. Can you briefly describe that program?
I'm sorry.
Briefly describe the program. What is the student assistance program?
The student assistance program is staff provided through the COAG group into certain school districts, well, all the school districts at different levels of service. It's to identify and assist students that have either a drug and alcohol problem, have the potential for a drug and alcohol problem, provide services and education to the school district and the staff, and then if appropriate to also assist them referring the individual out to appropriate treatment in the community.
Thank you.
Thank you. Emergency services.
Good morning, Commissioners. Ed Atkins, Department of Emergency Services. I have four amendments and one contract for your consideration today. First amendment is the Fifth Amendment to modify the lease with Pinnacle Towers for tower and ground space at the Glen Run Tower site. The lease amount will increase by from $13,296 per year to $37,296 a year. This will support the new microwave link to the King Ranch site and will provide for the extra antennas required during the installation of the Harris system and the transition from the E.F. Johnson system to the Harris system. The total amendment amount is $38,000. It'll run for 19 months from the 15th of April of this year to the 16th of November of 2015, at which time we'll negotiate a new lease to reflect the post-transition antenna loading on that tower. The second is the Fourth Amendment to modify the lease with Crown Atlantic Company, again for tower and ground space, this time at the Downingtown Tower. The lease amount will increase by $12,000 per year from $33,785 to $45,785. And again, this will support the extra antennas required during the installation of the Harris system, the transition from the E.F. Johnson system to the Harris system. The total amendment amount is $29,000. It'll run for 29 months, again, from the 15th of April of this year to the 16th of November of next year. And again, we'll renegotiate that lease to reflect the reduced post-transition antenna count. The third item is Amendment 9 in the amount of $152,759 $1,000 for the computer-aided dispatch contract with Northrop Grumman for software changes to the current CADs. It's required by the Pennsylvania State Police to support the new operating system for the Commonwealth Law Enforcement Assistant Network. Fourth item is Amendment 6 to the voice radio project with Harris Corporation. That's a result of the combined Chester County ACD Telecom and Harris team refining the overall system design during the customer design review back in September. Amendment 6 increases the value of the installation contract by $508,019. Some of the major changes in that amendment will be moving from White Clay Creek to Kemblesville. So that'll be a different tower site there. Changing the Emeryville tower site from a co-location tower site to a new greenfield site located at West Bradford Township property right by the state police barracks. Adding an additional tower at the Bucktown site, reducing the height of the planned South Coatesville site, and moving the secondary network control center from Poughkeepsie to Forestville. And the last item is a new 20-year lease with an option to extend an additional 9 years and 11 months with Crown Atlantic for tower and ground space on the tower at Fairview Cemetery. This tower will provide the microwave link to allow system continuity to the alternate 911 center at the Public Safety Training Center.
And are there any anticipated additional overall system design refinements involving remote sites that we may still hear further about, or is this the, was that sort of the laundry list of everything? And I know that I'm not, things can change, I get it, but do you, are there other things on the horizon that you can think of?
There's going to be a change. The Pottsville site is...
Pottstown. Sorry, a lot of people say that.
We're having some issues there. It's too close to the airport. It was misplotted when we applied, then that all came to light. That's getting in the too hard to do category. So we're probably going to move that site to North Coventry Township to the water tank. And that's looking very promising. And that's our game plan right now, is to make that change. And good luck on the tower site by the airport. That's going to be a mess with the FAA. That's the only major one I see on the horizon right now. We are still, might be a couple things we might have to look at down at Chad's Ford. We're getting into some interesting developments there as we're doing the negotiations for tower rental space and ground space. We do have an alternative there that we're exploring, but that's down the road some. But for the most part, the systems, the design is locked down. We did the factory acceptance test on the infrastructure a couple weeks ago. That went very, very smoothly. Now we just have to start installing the equipment once we have approvals at the various sites.
Thank you, Ed. We will move to facilities.
Good morning again, Commissioner Steve Fromnick, Director of Facilities and Parks. Today I have three amendments, one for the Justice Center, one for the Historic Courthouse, two for the Justice Center. The first one is with Westcott Electric to add additional branch circuits, feeder conduits, sump pumps in the elevator pit, pit lighting, and ground fault interrupter circuits for the elevator. The second one is with Allstate Mechanical. After we had building inspectors in there, they indicated they wanted to see secondary drainage under the HVAC units and additional smoke detectors in the return air ducts in the computer forensic unit room. And then Belia office furniture, there's a change in or amendment to provide for changes to furniture selected for the computer forensic unit.
Any questions? Thank you. Next, we'll go to Human Services.
Good morning, Commissioners. Kim Bowman, Director, Department of Human Services. I have contracts for both Human Services and our Managed Behavioral Healthcare Unit. The first contract is with Take Charge Consultants, and that is to support our workforce development efforts in the Human Services, targeting recruitment, retention, and staff development. For Managed Behavioral Healthcare, D'Alessio and Associates, and that is to provide psychological consultation if we have second-level grievance hearings in our Health Choices program. We also have a contract for Holcomb Associates for bilingual, bicultural education and outreach. It focuses on education regarding mental health and drug and alcohol issues, supporting healthy family development, and also ensuring that individuals are engaged in appropriate services. And actually, one of the key staff in that was recognized in Pennsylvania Latino Magazine recently as their Hero of the Month for the work that he has done down there, Luis Benitez. And finally, we have Paul Popolowski, and this is a provider network development within our Health Choices program to work with our mental health and drug and alcohol providers on enhancing their recovery management services.
Do you know the name of the person who was recognized for the Latino Hero of the Month?
Luis Benitez.
Okay.
With Holcomb.
Office of Aging.
Good morning, Commissioners. Wanda Stonebreaker, Director of the Office of Aging. I have two amendments this morning. The first one is for legal aid of Southeastern Pennsylvania. It provides an additional $4,000 of funding so they can continue to provide legal services for low to moderate income through the rest of this fiscal year, the state fiscal year. The next one is for Meals on Wheels of Chester County. Provide an additional $74,000 to assist them with their operational funding needs.
Thank you. And finally, open space preservation.
Good morning, Commissioners. My name is Diana Hoops, and I'm the Agriculture Programs Coordinator for Chester County in the Open Space Department. This morning, we have one farm coming forward, the Sean McCummings Farm, located in Lower Oxford Township, 13.51 acres. It's located on Duck Farm Road. This farm is a crop farm. The cost to the county is $54,040, and it's recommended by the Ag Land Preservation Board.
Thank you. We will move to our grants agenda, community development, followed by district attorney.
Pat Bockwitz, Department of Community Development. A couple of items on today's grants agenda, the first being a new award of funding from the Department of Labor and Industry, specifically some rapid response funds, which will go to help with some of our training initiatives at the CareerLink. The second is the application, which we spoke about earlier, that the resolution was attached, the Pennsylvania Department of Community and Economic Development, a new application for some additional emergency solutions grants funds, $131,457. Most of these funds will be used to rapidly rehouse families with children. These were extra funds that became available to them and made available to us. The last three items are somewhat, well, the two remaining to the Pennsylvania Department of Public Welfare are just normal work ready and earn program renewals for this program year. And then the second to last grant is from the Department of Labor and Industry, and that is our TANF, our Temporary Assistance for Needy Families, youth funds in the amount of just over $150,000. Two agencies that we fund there are Parksburg Point and Triskelis, who I know you met at the Phoenixville public hearing, I guess it was earlier this year.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Good morning, Commissioners. Lori Aguilera, Project Director for Chester County Highway Safety in the District Attorney's Office. Before you this morning are two contract awards. They're both renewal grants from the Pennsylvania Department of Transportation. The first one is for the Chester County Highway Safety Project in the amount of $105,568. And the second one is for the Chester County Sobriety Checkpoint and Expanded DUI Underage Drinking Program, and that is in the amount of $59,785.
Thank you.
Thank you.
MHIDD, followed by planning.
Good morning, Commissioners. Bridget Thrash, Chester County MHIDD. I have one grant for your review. It is a renewal application for Chester County Regional Education Services in the amount of $29,675. It is to support state-required training of therapeutic support staff who are providing behavioral health services to young 21 and under youth who are on the autism spectrum.
Thank you.
Good morning, Commissioners. David Ward with Planning Commission. I have one grant for your consideration. It's a technical assistance grant from the U.S. Department of Transportation to further advance our Pipeline Information Center website. It would be in the amount of $75,000 for the next fiscal year.
Thank you. Public Health.
Good morning, Commissioners. Sue Fox, Fiscal Coordinator from the Health Department. I have three grants on the agenda today. The first one is the National Association of County and City Health Officials. It's for renewal of our MRC grant in the amount of $3,500. The second grant is a renewal of our immunization grant. There's a slight reduction in that funding for $22,050. And the third grant is for our Title V program, and that award amount is $656,262.
Thank you. The finance agenda.
Thank you, Commissioner. We have several items on the agenda today. We have closed out budget change for 2013. Including those are expenditures for advertising that the Commissioner's office incurred in the past year. A couple budget changes related to putting funds into the proper accounts for the annual raises for some of the smaller departments. Also an allocation of the Marcellus Shale funds into the proper account, and also funds for specific accounts for ag conservation easements, again paid for by Marcellus Shale funds. The 2014 budget changes reflect all these reflect grant funds that are coming into the county and are being put into the proper account. We do have on the second page a budget change for emergency services to fund tower site security and software, which is funded by the Joint Regional Task Force. We have funds being put into the proper account to use Act 8 funds to buy some equipment for the Sheriff's Office. And two budget changes relative to ag easement purchases, putting them into the proper account. And also funds being put into a capital improvement account to replace the interior roof drain leaders in the Government Services Center. We also have several human resources policies that are being recommended for change. I'll ask Karen Florentine to review those with you.
Good morning, Commissioners. Karen Florentine, Director of Human Resources. We're recommending two policy changes. The first is an effective date of our health insurance coverage, and this is to make it compliance with the Affordable Care Act, which requires that we offer health care at the 90th day of employment. The second is a change in the limits in the dependent and daycare pre-tax expense accounts, the flexible spending accounts, changing the amount that can be set aside from parking expenses from $230 to $205, and transit expenses that are not reimbursed in any other way from $205 to $130. Those are changes that are being made by the federal government.
Thank you, Karen. We also have vouchers as submitted by the controller.
Is there this part-time to full-time change also? That was B and C were first, and then part-time to full-time.
Oh, yes, I'm sorry.
That's okay.
I apologize. Part-time employees who change to full-time employment, we are also making some changes, again, to make that consistent with what we need to do for the Affordable Care Act.
Thank you.
I'm sorry.
That's okay. They were backwards in the book from the agenda.
Public comment. Got the spring jacket out.
Commissioners, citizens, and media, I'm Alan Scott, a citizen engaged in counterintelligence, crime, and violence prevention. With the approaching commemoration of Passover, Easter, Holocaust Remembrance, crime victim rights, pain and suffering, and my own personal drama with the heavenly realms, kingdoms, underworld, and the universe, pay attention to my angelic words. I am a Jew, a child of God, a loving human being. Remember my sacrifice. Never again shall you forsake me. Why did you let it happen? Helpless to escape. This dedication is for all the Jews and God's children who lost their lives, souls, health, land, home, families, careers, names, cultural identities, and freedoms. It is for the children of the light, followers of secular or spiritual ways, and upstanding citizens who are unjustly crucified, hospitalized, institutionalized, incarcerated, brainwashed, treated as lower life forms or second-class citizens, physically, mentally, socially, politically, financially, religiously, and spiritually. Let God show us the truth, protect us from the world, and open our eyes and hearts to the injustices in our society's past, present, and future. Let us reflect, protect, ensure that no one is unjustly called upon, enslaved, ostracized, persecuted, tortured, converted, sacrificed, or targeted for physical, mental, financial, social, legal, political, religious, and our spiritual affairs. Why did you silence, inhibit, forbid, paralyze, disable, and obstruct me from helping? Why was I vilified, targeted, misled, enslaved, mistreated, immersed in water, violated, transfigured, murdered, reincarnated, and resurrected only to relive the nightmare again and again? Dear God, why have you forsaken me? I do not understand. All I ever wanted to do was to worship God and love in a healthy way, protect and serve, make an honest living, live in peace, walk with the light, and improve the world, and fight against the powers, principalities, and authorities who blacken the light, the truth, and the words fidelity, bravery, and integrity. Dear God, what does the universe want from me? Let us take action to help save the world from injustices by taking personal responsibility to do what is right by rising above the darkness. However, let God prepare, counsel, guide, and protect you before proceeding. May God, the Messiah, and all his children do their part in protecting, preserving, educating, and empowering us to create a more safe, secure, loving, and supportive environment. Dear God, I did my best. Bring forth your love for the world tragically needs your help. I have no more to give due to my unwanted messianic wounds. I do not understand how does an omnipotent, loving God allow such atrocities and pain and suffering to happen. Now is the time to stop the cycle of physical, mental, financial, social, political, legal, religious, and spiritual violence, corruption, and abuse. May our lives be filled with love, respect, healing, validation, redemption, and appreciation.
Anyone else have public comment?
I'd like to note the attendance of our elected public officials, Norma Queen, our controller, and Robin Marcello, our clerk of courts. Thanks for your attendance.
Board of Commissioners have decided we are not going to allow any more snow in Chester County for the balance of 2014. With that, we will adjourn until Thursday. Let Mother Nature prove us wrong between now and then.